was supposed to be a normal day. It felt normal. But then, I guess you always feel normal unless you know a catastrophe is about to hit. I didn't. Nobody did. She was just there one day. And she seemed normal. Nobody suspected anything. Nobody could have guessed what came next. She was unstoppable. And she was uncontrollable. Solitude suited me. I was a self-proclaimed geek who preferred losing herself in a good book or drawing rather than interacting with other people. People weren't exactly drawn to me, and I didn't make much of an effort to get them to like me. I minded my own business and they minded theirs. That's how it always was. Maybe I should have been more taken aback by the way she approached me out of the blue like she did.
No, that's pretty much
soft. Hi. Hi. You know, that's really good. Are you an artist?
Do you breathe?
That's funny. You're funny.
Yeah, thanks. Are you new or something? I've never seen you before.
Yeah, actually, I just moved here from Washington.
I have family in Washington. What's your name?
Don't laugh, okay? It's Venice. Venice Slayton. I like to be called Ven.
I like Venice. It's interesting. It's like the city in Italy, right?
Yeah, I've never been there. Sometimes I think my mom just looked around and saw a travel poster and named me after the first city she saw. Okay, well maybe it wasn't like that, but I mean, come on, what kind of parent names a kid Ven?
It's better than Katie anyway. Katie's boring.
That's your name?
Yeah, Katie White.
I don't think Katie's boring. It's a nice name.
Sure, easy to remember.
Impossible to forget.
Okay.
All right. This is coming along really well. Show me when you're finished, all right? Bye.
Whatever.
Hey, Katie! You're out here all alone?
Yeah, the person I usually eat with is gone today. Some distant cousin of his died or something. Went to a funeral down the street.
That's so sad.
What, that is that a funeral?
No, that you're out here all alone. I'll have one for
you. Don't have any food.
I'm not hungry.
For God's sake, have this. Don't starve yourself. Seriously, take it.
Okay.
So, why did you move down here to Montana anyway? Kind of step down.
Well, I kind of got into trouble at my old school. Nothing major. Just, I had this really bad, emotional breakdown. My mom, she didn't really want to deal with it. So she shipped me up here to live with my dad.
Wait, so your parents are divorced?
Yeah, as of 3 years ago now, I guess.
It's so crazy. Mine have been divorced for 3 years, too.
Seriously?
Yeah, sucks, doesn't it?
Big time.
I didn't understand why she was so fascinated with me, and I didn't know whether to be flattered or annoyed. She was just weird. She didn't seem crazy or anything. What was the harm in being her friend?
Hey, what's up?
Hey, how was Florida?
It would have been better if I wouldn't have had gone to a funeral and deal with all the grief-stricken relatives.
Get any soccer practice in?
Let's see. Slept on the plane both ways. had to deal with relatives I've only met once in my life. I had to take care of all the little kids at the funeral. And between all that, maybe like 10 minutes, the world is against me and my skills.
I'm sure it wasn't that bad.
Au contraire, mon ami. Anyway, how about you? How is your portfolio coming along?
Slowly. I think, to paraphrase you, the world is against me in finishing it.
Oh, please. What could have happened to you in these past couple days that is so distracting?
Okay, fine. I admit it. Not much. I mean, this new girl keeps bugging me every seventh period. I mean, she's kind of strange. Really strange, actually.
Alright, I'll keep my eyes open. Oh, I forgot. I'm supposed to text my mom. What are you looking at?
Oh, nothing.
Do you really think I'm strange?
Oh, I take it you overheard Zep and I talk about that.
You're avoiding the question. Do you really think I'm strange?
A little, all right. I mean, it's not a bad thing. To me and Devin, it's practically a compliment. It's not like we're being mean or anything.
I don't like him all that much.
Nobody said you had to like everybody.
He doesn't seem like a good friend.
And you don't know what you're talking about.
He left you alone. Friends don't want their friends to be alone.
God, he was at a funeral. What is your problem with that?
All I know is that if I had a friend who was going to be alone, I wouldn't be alone. I'm just saying that being alone sucks. You might not think so, but I can assure you, it's god awful. Stay alone too long. You tend to go a little crazy.
Somehow, I got the feeling that she was talking about that emotional breakdown she mentioned yesterday. And I felt a little bad for her, but not all that much. She was kind of acting like a lunatic.
With eyes that know the darkness in my soul, shadows on the hills, sketch the trees and the daffodils, catch the breeze and the winter chill.
I'm going crazy.
Cause I have other things to fill my time. You take what is yours and I'll take mine. Now let me at the truth which will refresh my broken mind.
Katie.
Hey. What's wrong?
Oh my god, you haven't heard?
What?
I didn't want to be the one to tell you. It's Devin.
What?
He was driving last night. He got in a really, really bad car wreck.
Oh my god, are you serious? Oh my god, is he gonna be okay?
He was dead by the time they got there.
Haven't you heard? I'm stuck on a verse. I'm stuck on a boy.
I'm glad it rained. Yuck. Devin would have liked it. He would have loved the world crying over his death. Not many people showed up. Seems like they were the only ones left that cared. A boy was killed in a car accident, and the killer just drove away. And still, life goes on. A boy was murdered, and life still goes on. Nobody's immortal. Thank God for that.
Just to kiss him, he doesn't know how I pine.
Hey, Still drawing angels, I see.
Go away, I'm busy.
With what? Drawing the same thing over and over again? Have you seen yourself lately? Oh, you look like a ghost.
I said go away.
You're practically dead.
Right
now. Wearing the same black shirts every day. Drawing the same thing over and over again. What are you, really?
It's none of your business.
Just waiting to die. That's all you are, a shell. A useless little shell.
Leave her alone.
I love 10 Venice, that's possible. Oh, no, we don't need it. I just want to shoot it. I'm probably not going to be in it.
What is his problem?
He's never liked me. To be fair, I've never liked him either. We're too different.
I hate him. People like that, the ones who don't know how to keep their mouths shut. The worthless ones.
Would you stop it? You're really freaking me out. All your talk of people and social injustice is weird.
You think I'm weird. You said it. You think I'm weird.
We're not back to this again, are we?
I'm your friend, Katie. I'm the only friend that you've got left. Think about that.
I can find other friends.
Fine. So do it then. She doesn't need anyone else. She just needs me. I need her and she needs me. We're the only ones that matter. The only ones.
Sorry I'm late. I just had to do some stuff. Mostly get my chemistry project done. All finished up. Yeah, I know I'm late. Yeah, I'll be there in 10 minutes. Alright. Hello? Is anyone out there? Let me out!
You've shamed people into silence your whole life. Now it's your turn.
Who is that? What do you want from me?
And so the predator became the prey. And the prey was devoured. A fitting end for someone who spent their whole life crushing other souls.
Get me out! Let me out of here! Let me out, please! Get me out of here!
The oxygen should run out in about 60 seconds. Enjoy.
Please, get me out of here right now!
Shh. It'll all be over soon. Be grateful. You get to escape. Others still suffer. But it'll all be over soon.
No, please, please, let me out! Please, let me out!
30 seconds.
God.
Hey, dude, did you hear about Gunner?
Yeah, I know. Yeah, like, seriously, that's
like,
just
I don't even know how that happens. Like, how does somebody die like that?
I know.
I feel
I'm
like...
I'm gonna miss him.
Yeah, it's definitely gonna be sad.
James. Like, what will we do? Like,
Mr. Morgan!
It's just gonna be so weird.
What's on this?
I know.
He sat right there. He sat in front of us. I don't even know.
What, you talking about Gunner's death? Of course I heard. Good riddance, I say.
Why are you? He's dead. How can you talk about him like that?
Oh, I'm sorry. I forgot. Every dead person is automatically saint. It's just taboo to talk about it. Is that right? So what should I do? Just keep my mouth shut? You can't say something nice and all that jazz?
Sure. Go with that.
Actually, no. Scratch that. I never had the right to keep my mouth shut. He was a horrible person, and I'm glad he's dead.
You didn't. You. What? You didn't kill him, did you? Tell me what chance
you wanted. It was you. You murdered
him. Over the next month, there were three more deaths. They all had two things in common. First, they were all seniors at my high school. And second, they all had something to do with me, and Ven hated them all because of it. She was really scaring me. She was killing all those people, and I didn't know how to stop her.
It's coming. The end. Soon everyone will know.
What, you're gonna turn yourself in?
I believe in truth. And all is the truth. It's right in front of you, but you've never been able to see it. You'll know soon. And you won't want to know, you'll fight it. But there's just no stopping it.
I don't want anything to do with your truth. I just want you out of my life.
Haven't you figured it out yet? We need each other. I can't go away, wherever you are. I'll be there too. There's your hint.
It wasn't long after.
Why didn't you kill him?
For the last time, I don't know what you're talking about.
We found prints at the last murder site. DNA samples. That's pretty incriminating evidence.
But I haven't done anything wrong. It's not me.
I have lab results that would attest otherwise.
But it's not me. It's Ven.
Ven?
Ven Slayton. Venice Slayton. She started going to school with me a few months ago. She killed them. She as good as told me she killed them.
Do you have any proof?
Well, no, but just get her in here. Talk to her. Ask her all the questions you've been asking me. You'll see it, I swear. Please.
Hey, Sneak.
Listen, I need you to do me a favor. Could you look up a Venice Slate in the school database? Just do it. The suspect is insisting she has something to do with it. Just look her up in the database. Really? We'll cross-reference the database with the school records. Alright. Thanks.
Miss White, I don't know what kind of game you're playing, but let me assure you, it is a very dangerous one.
Didn't you find her?
Miss White, there is no Venice Slayton in Central High. There is no Venice Slayton in Carolines.
No, she's there. Just check again, please. Anything, just check again.
I'm telling you, there is no Venice Slayton anywhere.
But that's...
You get it now?
How did you get in here?
You brought me here.
What sort of game is this?
Remember what I told you. You'll fight the truth. This is it.
What are you trying to do to me? Just stop it!
You know what's going on. You just don't want to admit it. Even now you know. This conversation isn't real. It's all taking place inside your head.
Stop it! Stop it! Just go away! Just leave me alone! You're a poison. You're infecting everything.
Stop fighting it. This is what you are.
Miss White, are you all right?
Can't you see her?
See who? There's no one else here.
But she's right there. No. It can't be.
It's coming. The end? Soon everyone will know. I've been leaving a trail, and it all leads to the truth. It's right in front of you, but you've never been able to see it. But you'll know soon, and you won't want to know. You'll fight it, but there's no stopping it. We need each other. I can't go away. Wherever you are, I'll be there too.
So how are you feeling today, Katie?
Fine.
Have you had any more hallucinations? Ven made any other appearances?
You keep trying to get rid of me. I'm not going away. I'm a part of her.
This isn't you, Katie.
Katie is me. And I'm her.
Please just make her go away. Make her go away. Push her out of your head, Katie. You have control, not her. She's only in your mind. You know that, don't you?
How rude, talking about me as though I'm only some girl's imaginary friend.
I'm not going away. This is my body as much as it's hers. Tell her to leave, Katie. I can't make her go away. She's ripping me apart from the inside.
Tell her to leave.
I can't!
It's simple. Just tell her to leave.
Oh, that's rich. It won't be that easy to get rid of me. I carved out her heart and sat in her soul. Katie White is me. And she is Ben Slayton. We're one and the same. And I am not leaving.
No!
Stop fighting me!
Get out of my head!
There. Happy?
No.
I'm not leaving.
I think it's time we try a more effective approach.
Electroshock therapy gets a bad reputation, but if used correctly, it's a highly effective way to get rid of people's apparitions, like your vent. Target the right area of the brain and she'll just fade away.
Will it hurt?
Some.
But it'll make her go away for good.
That's always the goal.
Then do it.
Katie, think about this. It's not gonna work. I'm not gonna leave just because someone sends a few electric shocks to the- Katie! Tell them to stop it. Tell them to stop it right now. What are you doing to me? Tell them to stop the machines. Shut the machine down, you little-
I don't wanna die. I don't want to go.
I will not leave. Not like this. Don't you dare think this is over. Don't you dare. I'm not ready to die.
How are you today, Katie?
I'm fine. I'm really fine.
No hallucinations?
None whatsoever. Is it true that I'm being moved to a group home tomorrow?
On a trial period, if things go well, you'll be able to stay there for a while.
How long is a while?
A few years, if everything goes well.
Then I suppose I won't be seeing you for a while.
I'll check in every couple of months. I'm sure you won't even miss me. You've made excellent progress this past few months.
Thank you.
Good luck, Katie.
Unseen lands, and I'm gonna take you with both hands and tell you it's the Did you miss me? Time.